I didn't cue this up, but we're gonna get birds. Oh, good, no birds. Well, good afternoon, my friends. Do I have a bottle opener? Oh, man, I forgot a bottle opener. I'll have to work on that. It's the Gaming Galleon. I'm Cap'n Raz. Nice to see you. Welcome back to Imagineering Central. Turn off reality. Turn off all the BS that's going on. I got to get this done. I got this deadline. When are you going to get this done? You know, leave me alone and let me be a pirate for 60 minutes. You know what I'm talking about? Man, oh man, a Shevitz. Everyone just needs to take a breath out there. You know what I'm saying? All right, so this is a weird show today. You know, I like to think that we try to keep... You know, we're not anal, but I at least want to keep some sort of semblance of a schedule for you guys out there so you know what you're getting into when you get on board the ship every week. And sometimes, and, you know, we're on a deadline here. It's every week. Every week. I know some of you may be watching this in reruns, maybe watching this in video form, but as real time goes, we have 1 week to get our voyage ready for Thursday, 4 p.m. Eastern. That's when we shoot. That's when we're live. If you ever wanted to see a show live, that's when you have to watch, okay? 4 p.m. Eastern. So we're on a deadline. Now, I plan. I try and work on the games that we pick. Obviously, we're out there hunting, looking for booty. And obviously, you know, you guys are working hard on the questions sitting in the bag that tells no tales that we address at the end of the hour. So everybody's working toward 4 p.m. Eastern Standard Time to get our little voyages off. But sometimes you hit a snag, or sometimes things get forgotten. And in this case, I forgot a very important detail regarding the Navigator. See, I really wanted to play this today. Our first PlayStation 4 game called Wild Guns Reloaded. That's some gloss right there, okay? Why did I want to play this? Wild Guns Reloaded is an excellent game about cowboys in a futuristic setting. Now, we got Josh coming down after the show. I don't know if you guys know this, but we're starting a little pirate band here on the ship. We haven't really come up with a name yet. I've kicked around a couple ideas. Mainly, it's just been me and Josh plucking away, and then people start sticking their heads in and seeing that we're doing something, and then they're trying to get involved themselves, a.k.a. Bismuth, especially. You know, our little band is growing slowly. Basically, what we want to do is do TV theme songs. And the one we're doing today, right after the show, is Firefly. You ever hear of Firefly? Show was out about 12, 13 years ago. You ever, I was going to say something really dark about him. Humanity sucks, but we'll leave it there. This is a show that died a lot earlier than it should have. It's basically about a transport ship, a smuggler ship, in the frontier of space. It's really good if you haven't seen it. And the song, the theme song itself is really good as well. So we're going to be doing that later. So I thought to get in the mood, we'd play Wild Guns. Because Wild Guns, much like Firefly, takes place in an outer space setting, but it's also blended with the Wild West. This game is not easy to come by. Or at least, it wasn't until recently. You see, this was originally a Super Nintendo game. And it is one of the best Super Nintendo games in the library. And as a result, it's really expensive. We're talking somewhere in between $150 and $200. Maybe $250 to get yourself an authentic Super Nintendo cart of Wild Guns. So when I heard that Wild Guns was being re-released with additional content to the PlayStation 4. I had to track it down. And did I find that out from network television? Did I find that out from GameStop.com or IGN? No. I heard it from some hole-in-the-wall retro guy on YouTube who actually, like me, is into this stuff still. He did a fairly competent review on it, and that was enough for me to know this is the time that I finally have a copy of Wild Guns on my own. Now, I believe I spent about $40 on this guy the day it released, or thereabouts, very, very close to it. Now you could probably get it around $30, and I would totally suggest it, because these are the kind of games that aren't going to get a lot of prints. And if you've followed PS4 at all, you'll know that PS4's releasing some games for very small, in very small quantities. And then they're stopping those sales. And as a result, these games are getting high in demand and their prices are getting high in demand. Now, does that mean this is going to go up in price? I'm not saying that at all, because this could always get reprinted. You never know when it comes to discs, okay? You never know. But a fine example on the PS4 is a game called Retro City Rampage. It's basically a Grand Theft Auto clone in 8-bit graphics. It was originally a downloadable game only. It's an indie game. And they made very limited amounts of it on disc before I even had a PS4. So it wasn't on my radar. Now, to find a copy, that's very hard. I believe those are running somewhere around $90. You know, maybe even more. So, but again, who knows? The company may just, Sony may end up making another 1,000 of those. I mean, we're still talking discs. We're still talking, you know, current hardware here. This isn't like, let's fire up our Super Nintendo cartridge making machines and make some Wild Guns. You can't really do that anymore. All that stuff's been stopped. Okay? So this is really the only reasonable way to get a hold of Wild Guns. So I was very excited to play it because of Firefly, because it's a great game, because it's interesting to talk about these games that no one's heard of for years coming back in actual disc form. And then I get here, we hook the PlayStation 4 up to the Navigator, and I forget that Sony hates us. What do I mean by that? I mean that they have a way to block capture of HDMI sources going out of their hardware. Now, we've always had this problem with the PlayStation 3. When every PlayStation 3 game we've played, you may notice, does not look as good as it does at home for you. And the reason for that is we do not capture, we do not have HDMI plugged into the Navigator for PlayStation 3. We're using old school red, blue, green composite, or is it component cables. So basically, we're having to downgrade the PlayStation 3 about 10 years in video quality just to use it for our voyages. And as for the PlayStation 4, we will never be able to play that game. We will never be able to plug a PlayStation 4 into the Navigator, because there's no way except for HDMI out. So we got it here, but went through all the trouble. We're 2 hours away to the show. I plug her in, and that's when I realize the Navigator is vomiting. And it's because it can't do PlayStation 4. It just cannot. So, we are essentially Adrift. That's what the PlayStation 4 did. That's what Sony did to us. We are adrift in space at this point. And I have no real destination for us. Now, do we still have booty? Yes, we still have booty. Do we still have the bag that tells no tales? Yes. Do we still have all you over here in the mess hall drinking grog and making snide comments about me? Absolutely. But do we have a destination? No. No. So as a result, I grabbed one game that I know nothing of, sitting in the hold. Couldn't be more foreign of a system to us than the Famicom. We have three Famicom games that we got for a buck each one day. And one of them happens to be a space simulator called Starluster for Namco. The people who made Dig Dug and Pac-Man and Tekken and yada yada. This was made the first year the Famicom came out. I know zero about this game. I know only that we're sitting in a cockpit, adrift in space with a radar in front of us, and a whole bunch of different points of interest that we can go to. So what better way to get into adventure than this? So without further ado, we're not playing Wild Guns. We're playing Star Luster for the Famicom. Let's get out there. Let's try and find our way to some civilization, if any exists. And then after about 10 minutes or so, we'll hit the booty segment, which is amazing. I'm dying to get into this. We'll explore a little more of Starluster, and then finally we'll come back at the end of the hour to address your questions, comments, and concerns right here in the bag that tells no tales. Okay? Let's get started. It's Starluster, adrift in space, somewhere in the unknown galaxy. Starluster for the Famicom.
Oh boy, where's my other? All right, so there you go.
Here we are. Let me get a little, I need my phones here. I can hear the, our control panel coming to life. Now, I played about 5 minutes before I got with you guys. We got into a scrap. I fought off some ships. And we lost a little bit of energy. You can see that in the lower left-hand corner. Now, on the radar here, I've got a little cursor. And it's going to let me go to any of these places. I don't know what any of this stuff is. Now, I went to an E before. And we got into a bit of a scrap. So let's go there first and just give out some bloody noses. Looks like the ship's in good shape. If we start to get in bad shape, we'll take a look at this other stuff. I don't know what a B is. Oh boy. I don't know what a B is. I don't know what a well, now I can't even see it. Looked like there were wavy lines there. Looks like the kind of stuff Peter Venkman would show you if you wanted to test your psychic abilities. Oh, come on. Oh. Oh. Woo! This looks beautiful, doesn't it? I mean, for an 8-bit game, I mean... whoa, what hit me? Wow, he disabled my shields. Look, they're coming right back up. Look at that, it was like an overshield. Now, what happened to my radar? It looks like he disabled it. Defend the base! What base? I know how to defend the base. Kill these guys. Oh my gosh. Where'd they go? There we go. Look what you did, you little jerk. Oh. Okay, there we go. Wow. I gotta admit, these guys are a little faster and a little smarter than the last crew I fought. Okay, there we go. Shield's down. Let's shield get back up. Alright, there we go. Ooh, structurals. Oh, man. We're at 40%. Star exploded. Is that good or bad? I think that's bad. I mean, we are the Star Lusters, after all. Last thing we want is dead stars. If anything, we want more stars. Now, is there some sort of... You're looking at all the readouts here? And, you know, isn't this the beauty of a Famicom game? Or a Nintendo game? You know, the mystery of what all this means. It looks like I've got some... Maybe a kill count on the left side of my radar there? Got about 5 pink things that... Whoa, it's a Death Star! No. Oh. Did I win or did he win? That sounds victorious. Yes! Huzzah! All right! Take that, Gaia. I'm my rank is Cadet Wang. I've heard that before. Most people call me Chief Wang, but, you know, I guess I gotta work my way up to that. This is interesting. All right, use time, right? Okay. All right. Well, that wasn't bad. Oh, now my stupid timer's all up. Anyone know when we start? Oh, yeah, we started. Of course I know when we start. We started at 4 o'clock. Okay. We said at the beginning. Is that it? Why is it restarting? Oh, we got to go again. Mission, destroy all enemies and defend the universe. We couldn't have killed all the enemies. Alright, well, let's take a look and see what just these wavy lines are. They've gone to plaid! Oh, asteroid belt! Oh, cool. I love how this is, oh yeah, I could do this all day. What a fun game! Yeah, they just give you a little, you know, radar's worth of playground stuff to just get involved in. I guess I gotta fly my way through this. Now, I think if you're trying to get to a certain letter, and there's like these wavy lines in between you and the letter, and you try and hyperspace through it, I think you might actually lose some health for that. So little areas like this, this wavy line asteroid belt area, sometimes it's a good idea to just slow down and blast your way through it. I'm gonna increase speed here. Try and get through it. Big field. Oh, defend what star? Oh, here's a radar. Is there anything? Okay, that star. Let's go there. That one's black. Didn't it look like I lost some energy doing that? Maybe I overheated the shields or the engines or something. Who are you? I saw you. Where'd you go? There you are. Hello? Hello? He's speeding away from me. Are you, be ye friend or foe? He's invisible. Is he cloaked? No, is that him? No, that's a star. You're an idiot. What star? I'm not seeing anything. Oh, man. This is what you get when you borrow a game from a buddy at school and don't get the instruction manual from him. I'm seeing something on my radar. One more go around here. Hello? Oh, screw it. Alright, let's go here. Maybe they blew it up already. Oh, okay, so what I'm using is some sort of, I don't know what that is. There's like some sort of missile I can use. Oh, what happened? Looks like they moved on to that B. We're gonna go to the B. We're chasing these guys down. It could be anything. Is your imagination running wild? It's a race of giant rabid hamsters. Giant rabid star-eating hamsters. Hmm. Hello? Man, I almost even want to get into a fight now. All right, I'll tell you what, let's just go get another. Oh, man, is it really 20 minutes? Wow. Star exploded! No! Oh, look at all the way over here. All right. We're going to stop right there. Mid-hyperspace. Mid-hyperspace travel will stop there so we can get this booty segment going on, which has been a real chore to hold off on. I think I got this gun ready. I think we might use it for the Firefly shoot later. One of the many Wii guns you'll find in thrift stores these days. Alright, so anyway, this is great. Yeah, I've been waiting on a long time to get this baby open. I think it was maybe last Friday? Last Thursday? Yeah, probably the day after our last voyage. I walked into the thrift store and got real lucky. Real lucky. This is the kind of lot where you know it was somebody's collection. Okay, you can see, and the beauty of it is it's a collection that goes over multiple systems, so you can see the worlds they traveled, the experiences they had, the memories that they'll live with for the rest of their lives, you know, all sitting in this chest. And it's good stuff. They had good taste. So let's get started. I saw a couple of games under glass. What was the first one that caught my eye? This was it. First one that caught my eye, right out of the box, starting strong, is Pokemon Y. And you're really going to ask yourself why this happened, because as you can tell with the grease paint here, the top letters there say 404. And then this, maybe if I take the box art out. Is that a reversible box art? Oh, it's the same box art. It's just, huh, it's interesting it's on the same side. But let's see what they said. Let's see what they said here. So 404, and then right under it, they crossed out 404, like, no, 202. I don't know why they did that, but, you know, whatever. There you go. So we got the game in there in nice shape. Got the manual. Right off to a good start, okay? And then I also saw, smacked in with some PlayStation 2 games, a PlayStation 1 game that got my eyes popping. I saw this right here. Strikers 1945. Let me see if I get the autofocus here today.
Just a second. Okay. We'll go with autofocus today. Let's see if that's going to bother us or not.
So yeah, Strikers 1945. So I was really excited about that because I know we've played Strikers 1945. Screw the autofocus.
Never works. I hate it.
We played Strikers 1945 when we went out to Berlin way, way back in the day. So it's a great little shooter, but I knew that we didn't have the manual for it. So here we had a nice, beautiful, complete copy of Strikers 1945, and what an awesome box art that is. Look at that! Is that not killer? Well, unfortunately, you open this guy up, and what do we have inside there? Gran Turismo 2. The arcade mode. This is arguably the better disc of the two. Gran Turismo always comes in arcade mode and a simulation mode. So that's kind of disappointing to not have another copy of Strikers 1945, but it's really great to have that manual finally, so we'll be able to take our copy of Strikers 1945, pop it in this baby, and have a nice complete copy. So pretty cool. It was really weird because it's just these two nice games, and I think this was here too. No, that's not true. It was like these two nice games, and then amidst like all these PS2 games that were either there usually or, you know, we have, no big deal. But then, for whatever reason, if this is where the counter is, there's like a second little standalone white wire DVD rack. Couldn't be cheaper. On its own, behind the counter. And on top of it, it's like, it was like a sampler platter at, like, you know, Applebee's or Fazoli's. It was just little tidbits of all of your favorites. Okay? And that's what I could see at a glance. And I was even happier because I realized that I had earned myself a card. Now, we'll get into that later. Who cares about the card? What's interesting here is we have the sampler platter. So let's go through it, okay? Speaking of Gran Turismo 2, here's a complete copy of Gran Turismo 2 for $2. That's about what these guys are worth, but it's beautiful. It's got everything in here. And I was really cavalier. I'm just going to tell you, I was really cavalier about what we did buy, because I knew what I had in my pocket was something I'd be holding on to for a while. If you spend $50 over a course of time at this particular thrift store, they give you a punch card, kind of like Subway. And if you punch enough, you get 50% off on one day's visit. And looking at this sampler platter, I was like, this is the day. I've been sitting on this card. Now is the payoff. So here we are. We're getting this guy for $1. Okay. Let's go do a little retroactive stuff here. Strikers. Looks like they had a 181 on there. So what's that come out to? 90 cents? And then $2 on Pokemon. It looks ugly now. Pokemon Y, so that's $1. $1 on Pokemon Y. All right, next. And this is when you start to realize this is some collections, because this is some obscure stuff. Tempest X Cubed. Tempest X Cubed. An Interstellar Galactic Battle Zone. I know we have a Tempest game sitting in the hold. These games don't really translate very well to the PS1. You really need a dial for Tempest. Maybe they were able to find a way around that with this one, but I don't know. But they're asking $1. They were asking 101 there, so we're getting this for 50 cents. All right? Yeah. Here's one that I was really excited. I remember passing on this one years ago for like $3.33, but it was just the disc. I don't know. I just wasn't having it. And here we are, a beautiful copy of Pandemonium Crystal Dynamics. This was made in a time when 3D was all the rage, but we hadn't mastered it yet. So this is one of those 2D, 3D hybrids. It's kind of akin to Klonoa. And again, they're asking 101 on this. You know, so you can see by the jester there. You can play either of these two, by the way. You play the chick or the jester. You really can't even... You know, she's getting chased by a dinosaur there. Whatever. So yeah, really excited to give this a shot. I've never played it. One player only. It's very, very early in the system's life. You know, disc looks like it's in really nice shape. Disc looks great. Really brilliant. We got this for 50 cents. Okay? All right. So, we're looking at a lot of PS1 here, right? We're looking at, for some reason, this guy had a 3DS. Who knows? One game here. But as I'm looking at this sampler platter, and I'm seeing black jewel cases, and my eyes are lighting up seeing PS1, I'm really elated to see right next to these black jewel cases some white jewel cases. And what does that mean? If you see white jewel cases, white spines, oh man, we're behind. We're talking Dreamcast. Can you believe it? Dreamcast games here as well. Outrigger. Now, I know this isn't, this is Black Label. They kind of did both. They have Black Label and white jewel cases. Outrigger is a shooter. Started in the arcade. It's a four-player split screen, I believe. Yeah, it is. It's an arena shooter. And, you know, Dreamcast controller really not that well made for an arena shooter. But this game is not easy to come by these days. And it's worth way more than the 50 cents that we paid for it. You can see right there by that guy's face there, it's a 101 they were asking for. We got it for 50. From the Sega All-Stars collection, Crazy Taxi. Great game, 101. We got it, we have it. Always happy to see another copy. And it's in nice shape. Yeah, that's pretty good. It'll play. Good shape there. Crazy Taxi. Here's one we didn't have. Very excited to find this. Choo Choo Rocket. 101. We're paying 50 cents on this guy. Doesn't have the manual, unfortunately. But this is a four-player. This was the first. Looks like somebody licked it. Or spit on it or something. We're going to have to clean that up. But this was the first online game. For Dreamcast. Yeah, this is the first one really, initial release that went. And it's an addictive puzzle game for four players competitively. In the White Jewel collection, we have Soul Calibur for 50 cents, made by Namco. They made Star Luster. They also made Soul Calibur. Gotta love it. We have this already, but man, I do not mind grabbing another copy of that. Somebody's gonna want that one day. Right? I don't know if we had this, but man, when I first got a Dreamcast, I sure did. Everyone had Tony Hawk Pro Skater 2, and it really plays well on the Dreamcast, so I'm very excited to have that. I don't know that we have it. It's one of those games that's just so common that unless I'm gonna buy it in a lot, like here, I don't grab it specifically, and I'm happy I didn't, because we got that for 50 cents. They were asking for $1.101 there. Okay, we got it for 50. Randomness. Wii Sports for 80 cents. That comes down to 40 cents for us. Do we have this? Absolutely. But it's in here, or it's not. It's not in here. Look, there were a lot of games, okay, and it was 40 cents. I didn't check. Here's a Dreamcast game I'd never even heard of, but I like it because it's rally racing. Test Drive V-Rally. 101. These games usually made it over the PlayStation also. But I think looking it up, I didn't see it for PlayStation, so this might be exclusive to the system. So we got that for 50 cents. Samba de Mingo! Oh, I meant to bring the maracas. We've had the maracas for some time. I found them one day at a thrift store for like 6 months ago for, you know, whatever, pennies. They didn't know what they were, but so now we have the game. Samba de Mingo. It's a rhythm game where you use maracas. Okay, eat your heart out, Guitar Hero. I'm playing my rhythm game with maracas. Jet Grind Radio. Really fun game. Great soundtrack. They were asking 101 on this. We got it for 50 cents. Beautiful. Beautiful. I already have a copy of this. Played a lot of that back in the day. A lot. But that's pretty cool. What Dreamcast collection would be complete without Sonic Adventure? Some people love it, some people hate it. I'm on the fence. 50 cents. I don't know, I've played a little bit of it. Certainly haven't beaten it, though. It's not demanded that much of my time. A lot of Dreamcast here, huh? And then, finally, on the same shelf with all these other Dreamcast games, a complete copy. Not complete. I think it's got the disc. They were asking $2. We got it for $1. Metal Gear Solid. Case is kind of beat up, so the discs are rustling around in here. There we go. Alright, that's okay. So yeah, that's not bad. $2, we got that for $1. Metal Gear Solid, Black Label. Alright, then I was like, dude, if I'm gonna do this 50 cent thing, I may as well just go for it, okay? Because if they're pricing these, you know, maybe they price the PS2 stuff pretty well. So I looked over at the PS2 stuff. We are way behind on time. Link's crossbow training. They were asking 80 cents there? 80 cents, so we'd be getting this for 40. Is it actually there? It is. I know I looked for this one because we didn't actually have this game. There's another game that you just pass over because you know one day you're going to find it for cheap. 40 cents is the right price, in my opinion, for Link's crossbow training. And on a side note, I remember walking around the store after I found these, and there was a bag, plastic bag with 2 nunchucks, a black nunchuck, a red nunchuck, which I don't see those every day, and then the Link, the Wii Zapper. I think they had $8 on that bag. For us, it would have been $4 since we were doing the 50% off thing. But I still felt like, I don't know, I felt like I was getting enough that day. So I left it behind. I feel a little bit of regret leaving that red nunchuck behind. We never see a red nunchuck, but whatever. Also, with the PS2s, we had Jet Moto for whatever reason. Jet Moto for 101. So we got it for 50 cents. Looks good. Looks complete. Another game that I don't think we've ever picked up because I always knew it's just so common that I didn't want to pay anything for it. 50 cents is acceptable for that. Another one that we have, but I always kind of enjoyed, a nice, beautiful, complete copy of Corvette. All the Corvettes you could ever think of. And some really interesting tracks. The tracks are really a lot of fun in this one. Pretty good technically sound racer. You know, there's 10 million of these on the PS2. But for 50 cents, I was willing to pick it up. A personal favorite here on the Galleon. Radiator Springs Cars. Made by THQ. And we got that for 50 cents. We were just picking up stuff we knew was good. You know, I think I looked at the disc to make sure. Yeah, she's good. You know, it wasn't even complete, but for 50 cents, we'll grab it. We'll give it to somebody bright in their day. Le Mans 24 Hours. I don't know that I've ever seen this one. 50 cents on this. Astonishingly fast, amazing, lifelike, and expertly tuned, unrivaled racing perfection. That's a lot of adjectives. Yeah, I don't know. Looks nice. Looks like in good shape. Why not? Looks like we got a game. Seem to have gotten a lot of games by InfoGames. I'm noticing. Another one you just don't see every day. Lucinda Green's Equestrian Challenge. Here's one to sit down with the boys. Get this going at a bachelor party, huh? They'd love you for it. Alright. Go Lucinda. 50 cents. A PSP game. This was, they were asking $2.02, we got it for $1. Medal of Honor Heroes 2. I mean, it's Medal of Honor, obviously it's some sort of first-person shooter. We like Medal of Honor here, Frontline's our friend. Okay, and then on the bottom rack of the sampler, we're already looking at classic PS1 games. We're looking at Dreamcast games. We got a PSP game in here, some PS2 games. We got a 3DS game. And then, just to top it off, hey, why not? Let's throw in a couple of Longbox PlayStation games. Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? You got Loaded for $2.42. Been looking for this one for the right price for a long, long time. It's a really psychotic Mortal Kombat-esque kind of top-down shooter. running gunner, almost like gauntlet. Look, there's blood all over the. You know, you combine gauntlet and Mortal Kombat, you pretty much got loaded. I believe it's two players. You know, you can be people like, there's like a giant man baby. There's a guy named Cap'n Hands. Sounds a lot like Cap'n Riz. And then the other long box, check this out. The original Street Fighter Alpha Warrior's Dreams. What did they ask? Oh, 242. So that would have been $125 for us, give or take, $125. So wow, huh? What are we looking at here? $125, $250, $350, $450. No, that's not right. $350, $4, $450, $5, $550, $650, $7. I can't believe all these Dreamcast games are 50 cents. $7.50, $8.50. $9.50 on the Wii Sports that doesn't exist. $9.50, $10.50 on the Pokemon. $11.12, $13.14. $14.50, $15.50, out the door for everything. How about that? That's magic. And just to add just a little serendipitous craziness to all this, just a few days later, I have been looking for Loaded and its sequel for years. And for whatever reason, I walked into a Salvation Army on Monday. They had a complete copy of Crash Team for $1. They had some strange game called Keelik the DNA. Imperative for $1. I think it's a first-person shooter. And then, all by itself, complete, Reloaded, the hardcore sequel. How about that, huh? And yes, don't worry. They put blood on the sequel as well. Okay, let's get going. That's it. Wow, we got out. That's magic right there. That was almost under $20 for everything. Hold on to those 50% off coupons for just the right time. And man, you're really gonna make a killing. Okay, let's get back to it. We got about 10 minutes. So yeah, we're good. We got 10 minutes. We'll play a little. We'll explore a little more Starluster. I want to see what a bee is, one that's not destroyed. So I think we're gonna go straight there. Hopefully, find something interesting. And then we'll address your questions, concerns, and whatnot in the mailbag. Let's get started. Oh, anybody see my harp? Allow me to don the harp of transition and send us back out into space. Starluster ho! Alright. Oh, that's such a pain of transition. There we go. Okay. Alright, back to it. Bopping around in space. I gotta say, not bad for a first year Nintendo / Famicom game. Where are you sending me? I know. Were we going to the enemies? We were in mid hyperspace, weren't we? Uh-oh, I'm getting something up. I'm getting a bad readout. Hello? BE, friend or foe? Why can't I see anybody? Ah! Ah! Where's the base? Where's the base? Which base? I don't know. Gotcha. Oh, come on. Is there a story? Is there a point to all this? In 1985, who cared? You're playing video games at your pal's house. You know what I'm saying? You make that stuff up. You fill in the blanks. Base exploded. Base exploded, no! I don't even know where the base is! Oh, there's Gaia! Yes! Alright, I want to go to a B. There are no bees left! They've been destroying all these bees! Hello? Anybody here in the sector? I really like the bleeps and bloops. Defense star, which star? You guys really aren't giving me a lot on this radar to go on. I was expecting, like, maybe a blinking thing. You know, I think in Star Raiders for the 2600, at least on the radar, they would blink the threat. Who's that? Captain, I have a blip on my radar. Captain, I have a nasal infection. Oh, come on. Do you guys want me to just turn this off and we'll just stare at the Wild Guns box art? Why can't I see you? Oh, come on. Which star? I'm going to go right down these guys' throat. We got two E's here. I want some action. I'm sick of playing Nancy Drew here. Nancy Drew and the mystery of the empty sector. Come here. Oh, yeah. I will say the combat's pretty clean. I think it's funny that we beat the game in like 3 minutes. like if only that happened now, that would be, you know, that's how you wrap up a voyage, you know what I'm saying? No, instead it's defend base. Base exploded. Oh, get back here, you fool. There he is. Got him. Oh. Aha! Woo! Oh my god. Tell you what, eat your heart out, Mass Effect. Uh-oh. Wait, I think that means we died. Gaia is destroyed and Big Bang is invoked. I'm relatively sure that means we died. Let's keep it there. I am a Cadet Wang. Yeah, you're a Cadet Wang. So, initially I thought that meant we won. I don't think that means we won. I think that means we lost. I think we lost. All right. Whatever. It's been a whole day of losses. Jeez. I tried so hard to get you guys a really cool, you know, game here. Wild Guns Reloaded. It just didn't happen. And I bring it up only because I don't see us ever being able to play Wild Guns Reloaded. Usually this is a game I would just... Well, we didn't do it today, but we'll figure it out down the line. I won't bore them with it. But we'll just never get to play Wild Guns Reloaded because Sony doesn't want you and I to play together. That's the big reason. The other reason is people need to calm down on retro games. They're not worth $150 to $250. I would love to get a nice copy of Wild Guns for the Super Nintendo. I realize we could probably get a repro copy for somewhere around $30, $40. I'm not sure that I'm really ready to encourage that industry. Say what you will of that. Okay. That was Starluster. Thank you, Starluster. I did have fun. I hope you had a couple chuckles yourself. Let's get over to the mailbag. Very chatty over here. Let's just take a look here, see if we have any questions. Does he play the games later? Asks Roll on the Floor Lapping Choppers. It depends. It depends on the game. I probably won't play this anymore because I do not have a Famicom at home. The Navigator is a much more sophisticated piece of equipment than anything that I happen to have at my homestead. So more exotic games like this we will keep in the hold. Just here for, you know, for the sake of this is the only place we can really play it. It depends on the game, though. Wild Guns Reloaded, for example, I would have definitely been playing that. I will keep playing that for months. It's a great game, and I would totally suggest if you're looking for, you know, something that's a little retro, but you don't have any retro hardware, go on Amazon and grab Wild Guns Reloaded while it's still around to be gotten. It all depends on the game. I definitely do, you know, I play a lot. I love video games. Usually, most of my video game time is devoted to getting us ready, but not always. And I play some modern stuff too. But anyway, yeah. So yes, I do play the games later. Anything else here? What's going on here? Anybody alive in here? Yes. Yes. We're alive. I love when people just... we get a lot of people who come onto the ship in just a daze. I don't know if, like, they're lightheaded from, like, the altitude change or something. They walk in, they're like, what is this? What's going on? Why, just take 5 minutes, pal. Watch what's happening. And then from there, maybe you can, you know, form some sort of idea as to what's happening. And then, you know, I write stuff like, you know, we're live only once a week. They don't read any of that stuff. They just go typing away. They're like, what's happening here? And then if they get no answer, they walk out. It's really funny. What's wrong with you? We don't have enough time to address that one. You're just going to have to make that... You're going to have to come to that conclusion on your own. But thank you for asking. All right, that's about it. I think we're done. I feel like I want to grab something from back here. Let's grab something from back here. Let's see what we got. Bag that sells no tails. Thank you. If you have a question, comment that you'd like to see put into the bag that tells no tails, you can write us at gaminggalleon@gmail.com. This comes from Filthy90. Filthy90 is asking, would you rather know the moment of your own death or the moment of the death of the person you love the most? Wow. Mine. Yeah, I think definitely. I think everyone would, wouldn't they? I mean, that way at least, you know, you don't have any loose ends. Right? I mean, we'd be able to know when to make the last show. When I'd have to hand it over to Bismuth. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah. There you go. Morbid ending to that. I shouldn't have even stuck my hand in there. I think that's it. If you have a question or whatever or more that you'd like to send us here to the Gaming Galleon, you can send it to the Gaming Galleon, P.O. Box 199254, Indianapolis, Indiana, 49216. Just no anthrax, please. We don't like anthrax. We're allergic to anthrax. Okay, that's it. Thank you very much for coming. It was a fun adventure. I had a great time, and I can't wait to sit down with these Dreamcast games and have a good time with them. I hope that you have a nice week. We will see you next time. I hope. And I'm not sure where we're headed. I'm not sure what we're going to do. But I know one thing. We're going to have a good time doing it. And hopefully we can do it together. So, until next time, my friends. What I do to ye Spanish maidens. What I do, ye ladies of Spain. For we received orders for to get stranded in space. And we may never see ye fair ladies again. Keep your powder dry, mateys. Oh, and order wild guns while it's out there.